From a very early age, I always wanted to be a doctor. I was always really fascinated by the disease of cancer. I mean, my grandma said, what do you want to do? What do you want to be when you grow up? And I said, oh, grandma, I want to cure cancer. So I graduated from the University of Melbourne and ended up working in the field of cancer medicine. I did my PhD at the Walter and Eliza Hall Institute of Medical Research. And we were trying to understand the complexity of the breast, in particular to try and discover in which subtypes of breast cells arose breast cancers. We discovered that there are in fact many different types of cells that are resident within the breast. We also figured out what their relationships to each other are, and then worked on trying to identify in which of those subtypes of cells develop breast cancer. The idea being that if we know that, we can figure out better ways to prevent the disease. The discovery really changed the way that people all around the world went about doing breast cancer research, because it enabled them for the first time to identify these subtypes of breast cells, particularly to figure out which of them causes breast cancer. The day when I looked down the microscope and saw that we had grown an entire normal milk-producing breast from a single mammary stem cell, I can say that day changed my life. From that moment on, I was bitten by the research bug and I wasn't going back. The effect of research on cancer treatment over the last 30, 40 years has been profound. All the major common cancers, breast, bowel, lung, etc., have improved survival rates of sort of around 20% or so over that period of time. But there's one standout, and that's the disease of melanoma, where there's been no improvement in overall survival in that time. So I went to the US to work on the disease of melanoma, and we set about trying to test whether or not stem cell biology could be applied to that particular disease. Through the research, we developed a method for the first time ever to grow tumours in the laboratory from single human cancer cells. So that had never been done before. But what that's now enabled us to do is to really dissect at the level of individual cells human cancers and reveal this fact that fundamentally this disease is highly adaptive and highly evolutionary, and at least in some cancers, pretty much every cell within that tumour is different from every other cell. There were opportunities here at the Peter MacCallum Cancer Centre provided for me to continue doing the work that I was doing. Our research has revealed the fact that cancer cells can change within patients. At the moment, the way that we do cancer research and the way that we treat patients does not account for this fundamental evolutionary nature of cancer. My hope is that the research we're doing into cancer evolution will result in really paradigm-shifting ways in which we treat this disease.